The U.S. Air Force recently tested Lockheed Martin's Advanced Test High Energy Asset Anti-Drone Laser. Advanced Test High Energy Asset, or Athena, also the name of the Greek goddess of war, was used to take out drones. The laser defense system knocked out several drones out of the sky, demonstrating that it can handle multiple threats per engagement. As per reports, the system shot down multiple Class 1 and 2 fixed-wing and rotary drones at a government-owned training range at Fort Sill, Oklahoma. It's important to note that this is the first time U.S. Air Force personnel used the system independently without Lockheed engineers. In this video, Defense Updates reports on the successful testing of Advanced Test High Energy Asset. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game, War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles, from the 1930s to the 1990s, and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. So grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. The proliferation of drone technology has meant that the chances of facing asymmetric threats are much more than it was a decade ago. In January 2018, Russian forces faced a drone swarm launched against Khmeimim Air Base in Syria. The Russians were able to neutralize these drones. Though the attack was able to inflict limited damage, it indicated that the threat of the drone swarm had arrived. A recent example is the September attack on Saudi Arabia. On September 14th, facilities of Saudi Arabia's oil company, Aramco, located in the east of the country, came under attack. As per reports, the raid began around 4 a.m., and drones as well as cruise missiles were used in the attack. There were 18 drones and 7 missiles. The world's biggest oil refinery, near the city of Abqaiq, and a refinery near Kuwait, where Saudi's second-largest oil field is located, were targeted. This kind of scenario can occur in U.S. Air Force bases, too. A swarm of cheap drone armed with small explosives could cause massive damage to multi-million dollar warplanes, radars, etc. The adversary could potentially cause a lot of destruction without having to put in significant resources. For example, a Lockheed Martin F-35 Lightning II costs around $80 million apiece and could easily be disabled by a grenade-sized warhead. John Rood, Undersecretary of Defense for Policy, recently stated, "We're seeing asymmetric investments in things like swarming UAS technology, like unmanned aerial systems that really fly more like cruise missiles. It's a serious problem." Rood didn't specifically mention the Saudi attacks, but indications were clear. So it's clear that the U.S. military needs to address the growing challenge of targeting small, basic, but potentially lethal drones. This is where laser weapons come in. Lasers are concentrated beams of light that transmit large amounts of electromagnetic radiation against their targets. The power of a laser is generally stated in kilowatts. The general idea of laser beam weaponry is to hit a target with a train of brief pulses of light. The rapid evaporation and expansion of the surface cause shock waves that damage the target. When a laser beam strikes a target, it can cause the external surface to heat up rapidly. This can cause a drone to burst in the sky as its battery pack or fuel tank ignite. Even if this doesn't happen, the laser could fry the electric sensors and communication modules of the drone, which will make them lose contact with its operator and deplete their ability to navigate, ultimately disabling them. Lasers have some very important advantages. The speed of light enables them to hit their targets almost instantaneously. Laser weapons also don't need to carry ammunition like traditional systems, and hence they'll be able to take out a much larger number of threats, constrained only by the power supply limit of the platform. They're also much cheaper and could cost as little as $1 per shot. This is much more cost-effective than deploying traditional weapons. For example, an FIM-92 Stinger short-range shoulder-fired surface-to-air missile has a price tag of $38,000, and a Patriot surface-to-air missile costs around $1 million each. As per Lockheed Martin, Athena is a prototype laser weapon system that's designed to defeat close-in, low-value threats such as improvised rockets, unmanned aerial systems, vehicles, and small boats. Athena is a transportable, ground-based system that serves as a low-cost testbed for demonstrating technologies required for military use of laser weapon systems. It's a 30-kilowatt laser weapon system that uses the 30 kilowatts accelerated laser demonstrated initiative Aladdin laser. Aladdin combines the power of three 10-kilowatt fiber lasers into a single 30-kilowatt beam. The use of multiple lasers means it can also operate at lower levels, say 10 or 20 kilowatts if required. 30 kilowatts is sufficiently powerful to knock down drones. Lockheed said in the release, "The radar track was provided to airmen who operated Athena via cues from the C-2. Then Athena's beam director slewed, acquired, tracked, and defeated the drone with a high-energy laser." Lockheed spokesman Mark Lewis told Military.com, "The Air Force focus is to field test and evaluate directed energy systems for counter-drone capability and readiness for fielding for air-based defense mission. Meanwhile, the Army's focus has been to determine what capabilities, directed energy and C-2, will facilitate the defeat of aerial threats for the Maneuver Brigade and Maneuver Battalion," he said. "That includes defense against mortar attacks." The new test follows two previous experiments by the U.S. Army in 2015 and 2017. The fiber laser, equipped with advanced beam control technology, took out five outlaw drones at the Army's White Sands Missile Range in New Mexico in 2017. Laser technology is still relatively new, and scientists and engineers are working round the clock to master it. There are many challenges when it comes to using the laser for combat usages. American military's tryst with laser weapons isn't new. In 2010, the Air Force mounted and fired off a megawatt-class chemical laser from a modified Boeing 747. Things have changed since then, and instead of unstable chemical laser used for that experiment, solid-state lasers are now being used. The SHIELD program is developing a directed energy laser system that will act as a demonstrator for a self-defense system that could eventually enable aircraft to protect themselves from surface-to-air SAM and air-to-air AAM missiles. On April 23, 2019, the U.S. Air Force Research Laboratory, AFRL, Self-Protect High Energy Laser Demonstrator, SHIELD, Advanced Technology Demonstration, ATD, program successfully achieved a major goal. A laser developed as part of the program had shot down several air-launched missiles in flight. The system could be deployed as an add-on pod in the future. In August, the Air Force awarded Raytheon Space and Airborne Systems a $23.8 million contract for two prototype high-energy laser weapon (HELW) systems, designed to take out unmanned aerial systems. A news report published earlier this year states that emerging counter-drone technologies, both for civil and military use, are on the rise and will see an increase over the next decade. It's evident that lasers will have a significant part to play in future combat, and they're becoming reality much faster than what we could imagine a decade earlier.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.